Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Tech Labs Cup Season 2 in the Minsk LAN event. We got Power Rangers facing up against Virtus Pro in the grand finals. The loser will walk away with $3,000, actually. Pretty good prize, gotta say. The winner will walk away with $5,000 and also ensure themselves a slot in the grand finals that happens in Moscow in December. So let's go ahead and jump right into it, guys, as I welcome in my new co-caster. Pitmuckle went ahead and was going to cast the Bounty Hunter series, so we now have Durka going to be joining us on the microphone. What's going on, man?
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. Even though, you know, the Americans would usually be saying good morning, but apparently you just woke up late night.
Yeah. Well, no, kinda. I went to bed at 2, but it's been a long, long week. So my sleep debt, I've been catching up.
Fair enough. I understand that entirely. I had a couple different nights here over the last couple of weeks. So I was just like, slept for 12 hours. I think the biggest one was like, I slept for like 15 hours straight. I woke up for like about 10 minutes at some point in time. Like, you know, got up, went to the bathroom, drank some water, fell back asleep. So a total 15 hours of sleep that, I don't think I've ever slept over literally half the day before like that.
No, this is the longest I've slept in a long, long time. I even set an alarm for 10:30 in the morning thinking, you know, that's going to be good. I'll wake up feeling nice and fresh. The alarm goes off. No.
Your body's like, nope. It's time to cash in, friend. It's time to cash in. You're drawing out the sleep too much. All right, man, let's talk about this draft. We got Wisp, Invoker, Lycan, and the Disruptor all being banned away by Power Rangers. The Furion, Doom, Shadow Demon, and Ancient Apparition banned out by Virtus Pro, and they're going to take advantage of that. They grab themselves the Batrider and the Terrain Protector, but looking at that and going, the Disruptor's banned away by PR, sure, we'll pick up the Brewmaster. One of the biggest counters to the Brew is already out of the pool, so they grab that highly valued hero while Power Rangers picking up the Marana, and as always with PR, they grab themselves a Vengeful Spirit.
Yeah, they do love that, don't they? I'm just wondering now, like you said, the Disruptor has been banned out. Do they try and go for something like a Silencer, which has been coming back into the fray as of late, but more in a one role? Play it as that hard carry? Because you need something to stop that Brewmaster getting his ultimate off in the mid game.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's I just can't get over the fact that Power Rangers pick up the Vengeful Spirit again. So they ran it as like in their match up against Relax, they picked up Vengeful Spirit in the D2CL as a support. They did it two different times up against Relax in the Tech Labs, where one was a support, the other was a core. They just love this hero, man. They managed to make it work. They're the only team, pretty much, that makes it work as a core position.
Yeah, I think even Na'Vi has tried it once or twice, but they've never gone back to it. Mm-hmm. Avos played a pretty good Venge back in the day. But when you see PR pick up the Marana, usually it's Moon on that, and they have the Venge as a support. So look towards that, I think. But their third pick now is going to be vital for them. Virtus Pro, Batrider, Treant, Brew, such an annoying lineup to go against. When you've got Bat without living armor, just able to, you know, jump over the top of your supports on that offlane.
Mm-hmm. Well, Darkseer is now going to be grabbed, so that's going to be your offlane hero picked up for Power Rangers. They may get themselves a nice little teamfight combo off of that. They don't have any obvious vacuum combinations, even though every single time I've actually been running into that a lot lately. I just think Darkseer is so powerful when you have some sort of AoE stun to be able to combo it up with, but I can't tell you the number of times I've gone through a draft and been like, oh, the Darkseer's picked up. Let's look for an AoE disable, and the team probably picks up zero. Still works well. Darkseer is still strong in many other platforms. Remaining. It's just the fact that that's the one thing my mind instantly leaps to is, all right, let's get a wombo combo.
Yeah, he's always used as sort of this conduit in a draft where he's a middleman, basically. You have someone to start the fight. He comes in and vacuums. So you have someone like a Centaur bait or jump in and get, you know, three-man stomp, and you vacuum into a bigger combo. But they've got Marana, Venge, very single target-oriented. Skyrath. Have you seen much of that, Tech Labs?
No, I haven't. Skyrath, this will be a first for Tech Labs, at least. So the Skyrath Mage, It's possible that this is a core Skywrath mage and he could be going mid, but it's much, much more likely that it's going to be a regular support Skywrath mage, and we are still going to see the Brewmaster in the mid position. But now, actually, something I do want to mention just you, since I know you didn't see it, but this is 10 seconds. We now see Brewmaster very highly valued, being picked up all the time in the 1-2 area, sometimes in the 3-4. But I have now seen Brewmaster in all three of the core positions. We've seen him mid all the time. That's his classic role. We have seen him in aggro or even some defensive tri-lanes as the one position. And Power Rangers brought it back last game. I've seen it before then, but it's the first time in recent memory anyway, where the support Brewmaster came into play. FNG played a support Brew last game. It worked out wonderfully for them.
Yeah, I think it was VP that played it in the EU qualies as well as a support. It was a bit odd. I'm pretty sure they lost the game.
Oh, that's right. I forgot about that game.
He still managed to get a blink sort of 15 minutes in, even though their game went really rough the first 10 minutes.
Mm-hmm.
I still think it's a hero that needs a lot of levels. But then again, it's one of those weird ones where he's so ultimate reliant, and his ultimate, you know, it's got a lower cooldown than it used to. He isn't that item dependent anymore. Once you get blink arcanes, he doesn't need much after that. He's just a great initiator. We've seen him in a solo safe lane role as well a couple of times. That was a CIS team as well in the EU qualies. I can't remember who it was. He was up against the tri lane, and you know, he went into the jungle just to get away from who he was facing. Virtus Pro's
turn to pick. Well, we're going to see the puck now picked up for Power Rangers, so there's some AoE there. There's some AoE to work out with the Darkseer. They do have a fairly squishy lineup here, especially the puck being picked into the Skywrath Mage like that. Very susceptible to burst damage, and Virtus Pro, well, for their hard carry, they're going to get the ultimate hero in burst damage. They grab themselves the Morphling.
Like, silence on Skywrath Mage is amazing. I'm not sure about that puck pick, because he relies so heavily on, you know, phase shifting out of damage, using that Illusory Orb, silence, Dream Coil. If he gets silenced by Skywrath, he's going to get absolutely dominated in these teamfights. But Moon picks up that Slark, so we're going to probably see aggro try with the Venge, Mirana, and Slark, and then have the DS safe lane.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that sounds about right.
Shut down that Morphling.
Yeah, they got to be really scared of the Morphling here. I mean, the Skywrath Mage was a really smart pickup for them, right? I just like looking at what Power Rangers had. Prepare that silence is just going to decimate them, and the early harassment of a Skywrath Mage is also going to be really threatening. As long as they don't get punished early on in the laning phase, then I think they're golden going into the mid game. They've got so much teamfight damage, and they still have the pick-off potential of the Brewmaster. Combine that with the split pushing of what Illidan's going to be able to provide you, and they even have a little bit of turtle with the Terrain Protector. If they're able to just get just enough to be able to combat Power Rangers in these early pushes that they're going to have to try and do, and they're able to push back Power Rangers and keep those towers up for a little bit longer, it's going to be a huge benefit for them. But Virtus Pro, they are five-manning into the Roche pit just to make sure. They probably saw PR. They pulled off a sneaky little level one Roche earlier. FNG is going to be able to stun up NS. The arrow lands on Jotun, but unfortunately it's on the tankier hero there, and FNG is copping a lot of damage, so Power Rangers are going to be forced away in the process, and Virtus Pro will return from whence they came.
So in these bigger team fights, when VP are going to be looking to fight sort of three or four man in a four-man group with the Batrider, Brewmaster, Treant, and Skywrath, it's going to come down to how well NS prioritizes his silence on the Slark or the Puck. Because with that long-range concussive shot, it's going to give them the space to catch up. The Treant get Leech Seed, Brewmaster blink over the top, Batrider with a blink as well. Their initiation range is absolutely massive, but then on PR side, they've got great escape mechanisms and great counter-initiation and chasing capabilities with Surge and Pounce and Shadow Dance. But with Slark and Puck, like I said, heavily reliant on their spells, this silence from the Skywrath Mage is going to be pretty big.
Absolutely. We're going to see a quick rotation, possibly into the mid lane. They grab themselves a Haste Rune. Looks like the ping's already coming out that they know that the ward is going to be placed over there. Cheshire Cat's going to be dealing with a lane that's going to cause a lot of harassment, but he should still be able to pick up level 2. The instant silence is still going to be a big threat even after he gets Surge.
Yeah, definitely. Oh, wow.
Oh, no. Well, the Pounce, Magic Missile, Pounce, Arrow, they've got a lot of lockdown between those three abilities, so I shouldn't be too surprised that they picked up the Batrider already. And Arnsheart going to have to make the decision whether or not he's going to continue to go back to the lane. Yeah, he's going to try and pick up level 2. But he may regret this. If he dies again, like when he could have just jungled from the beginning. It's always the biggest hassle I have. When you're dealing with a really tough defensive tri-lane that has a lot of kill power, why not just try for the jungle in the start? You know? Instead of giving away 2 or 3 kills before you're finally forced away.
It's like a lot of the time we used to see Darkseer and Batrider especially go into the jungle straight off the bat before the creeps spawn, get level 3 and then go to the lane to try and get their level 6 and harass the supports. Because Batrider at level 3, he can, you know, go over the top of this Venge and Mirana and make their life a living hell. Or did VP actually ward any of the camps up in this top lane? No, they didn't. They've got 2 wards watching the rune spots.
Yep. Clamp being laid down, Scandal. Yeah, the new change to Brewmaster actually makes him pretty damn good versus the puck. Like, he's already decent. Was already decent, at least. But the change to Drunken Brawler ensuring that crit. The crit does so much damage up against the puck. Like, he has okay armor. But he just has such a low health pool that he's so susceptible to that kind of play. God does the smart thing, though. He backs up to his bottle, heals himself up fully, and sends the bottle back. So he can still get the bottle crow without putting the courier in any real danger.
Yeah, and one of the great things about Puck usually is the ability to trade hits with your opponent in the mid lane. But when you've got that dedicated crit, you know, almost always ready for you in the clap as well, using phase shift to dodge Brewmaster's attacks. Oh, AA on top lane. Look at Smile. He's jumping around this chasm. But
J4?
The Mirana.
Jesus. J4 almost died there.
Cutting it a bit close.
Yeah, just a little bit there. Art, they were trying for it. Invis Vengeful Spirit was revealing Batrider, but the magic missile came out too early. If they had thrown the arrow and he'd waited on the magic missile just for an extra half a second or so, they probably would have landed it and would have been a quick, easy kill for them. But he got a little too impatient, and the result was arrow completely missed. 20-6 on the Morphling, 17-5 on the Brewmaster. So all in all, Virtus Pro doing a good job controlling their lanes, despite the fact they fed away First Blood.
It's fine.
It is fine.
Like, Darkseer's had completely enough of that Skyrath Mage harassing him out of the lane. So we see both team supports just trying to farm the jungle, get their level 2, 3. And once we see Skyrath on 3 with... He'll probably go 1-1-1. I doubt he'll go for a second in Ancient Seal, because that concussive shot's going to give the Treant such a great chance to catch up to whoever they're ganging, and they could probably even try mid.
Yeah, that's not a bad idea.
Yeah, G's got his boots, he can catch up pretty well. Concussive shot, slow Scandal down. They've got to get there before he can orb and phase shift away, so they'll probably try and time it when he's last hitting with the orb.
Mm-hmm. Well, we may see the other side. J4 throws out an arrow. Not able to grab God, though, hiding behind the creep wave. So he'll be good. J4 is just going to go back from there. He was already so low. He was on his way out. He just threw out an arrow for an arrow's sake. Batrider is getting to his Tranquil Boots, so he is actually now level 3. Like you said earlier, he's going to be able to do a lot to actually intercept a lot of these pulls from the supports. So he's now got a little bit better options in that regards with the aggression that a Tranquil Boots allows him.
And MS doing a cheeky little stack on that hard camp down there.
Oh yeah, NS setting it up later for the Batrider to be able to clean through. I was like, what hero? What hero's going to be cleaning through? Oh, the Batrider. There it is.
Yeah, I was like the same thing. Is G going to go down there? No, oh, of course it's Batrider on the squad.
Yeah. Puck picking up his boots now. Knows he needs that extra movement speed. He cannot afford to be at a MS discrepancy up against God's Brewmaster. He's already having a hard time. God has been doing a really good job of trying to force out the inopportune phase shifts by just spamming out clap. And Scandal cannot afford to let that hit him. He has to dodge it when he's close range with the Brewmaster. Another arrow comes out. Not the right time, though. And Brew with the haste rune. Never know when he's going to start going crazy on the puck.
Yeah, J4 is wasting quite a lot of time over here. I'm surprised they didn't just wait for FNG to come around, and G obviously spots this, that ward up there.
Yeah, in fact, he's going to go for the supports here. Gets the stun. Oh, the clap doesn't go out in time. Now the follow-up arrow. FNG.
He's still hasted.
Yeah, he's still hasted, but unfortunately, it looks like they're going to make it back to the Tier 1 tower in time. NS, he didn't actually go for a concussive shot, which makes sense. The harassment of Arcane Bolt is strong at level 1, but you want that disable as soon as possible. So maybe if he had concussive shot, he would have been able to slow down one of those supports, but... As is, well, they do kill the Rune Ward, but that was only going to be up for another minute and a half or so anyway, so not too big of a deal. And they are leaving the Batrider, continued alone with the Slark. Now, Slark definitely can kill the Batrider, but it's not that. They need the added pressure to be able to force the Batrider completely out of lane. Darkseer now picking up the Soul Ring, so he's going to be able to... Just spam out those iron shells in the bottom lane. Looks like he's going to be sitting on the rune. It's going to be top. So, Invis rune going to go the way of Scandal.
Try lane mid, guys.
I guess
three
so,
versus
man.
Three
versus three. This is kind of ridiculous, but we've had a lot of slower paced CIS games the last couple times. Not the old crazy CIS that we used to see that involved like. 15 kills by 10 minutes in.
Yeah, VP really surprised me during the TI4 qualifiers how slow they can play. Because I'm so used to them just, you know, balls against the wall, charge against the enemy as often as you can, try and get as many kills as possible. But they really did show that they can play that sort of passive style rather than completely going nuts.
Yeah, and it was to the benefit of the team as a whole that they got that sort of extra bit of discipline. They looked like an entirely different team, honestly. Like, I remember watching the semifinals and going, "This is not the same Power Rangers, or this is not the same Virtus Pro that I have been watching for the last 2 or 3 months." Because Virtus Pro has been showing up in so many Gigabyte challenges and Dota 2 Champions League and so many other tournaments that. I've cast them over and over and over again. It's just kind of like, oh, it's Virtus Pro. They might be able to win early and snowball there, but good chances are, even if they do win early, they often throw away that lead. Arzar playing a very dangerous game right now. If he gets in range, the Magic Missile, the follow-up arrow stun mixed in with the Pounce that's going to be coming in as the Slark gets close enough, he's got to be very dangerous of what is basically a three-stun tri-lane.
You could see he's just sitting on the edge of the cliff, making sure that he's always got a route to escape.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, down in the Radiant Jungle, though, Cheshire Cat's found one of the stacks.
Oh, cheeky bastard's going to be able to steal a lot of experience away from Virtus Pro. They're hoping to be able to keep that for the Batrider. Haste Rune now going to be picked up by the Darkseer, snags that one, and is going to have some more fun with Jotam.
Okay, do you remember when we were talking about... Oh, Darkseer's going to chase the Treant. Oh!
Oh god, he's chasing him down. Jotam gets a little juke in action, though. He'll be good. He'll be good. That is, if he doesn't reveal himself sometime soon, Scandal's going to be coming in. He does have a 2-level second science. Yeah, he has that.
The thing which makes Illidan useless and can't run away.
I couldn't decide whether I was going to say second level in silence or 2-second silence, which isn't actually true. It's 1.5 seconds, but...
Close enough.
Either way, the Invis rune means they're just going to be able to burst down the Morphling.
But yeah, do you remember we were talking about Midas on heroes like Wraith King, where he wants to get his level 16 faster.
Yeah.
And then I made the point that we never see heroes like Brewmaster get Midas, even though he's in the same situation. He wants to get that level 16 as quickly as possible. Experience is a great asset for him. And G builds a Midas, so I'm wrong.
Yep, we had a Midas earlier. As well on the Brewmaster, one of the core Brewmasters that we saw. It wasn't the support Brewmaster. It wasn't like a catch-up Midas, but yeah, it was Midas Brewmaster. I don't know. I mean, it does slow down your... If you're in this sort of scenario, Virtus Pro, they want this game to go long. I don't mind it so much. Just because of the fact that they don't need to be the aggressors at this point in time. They're not trying to force team fights right now because they want this game to go... longer for Morphling to get more chance to farm up into a carry position. It's on Power Rangers to be the aggressors, so when they're forced to initiate on you, you don't necessarily need a Blink Dagger.
Yeah, and you've always got Batrider as well. And Moon gonna Radiant's pounce away from this. Tower is under attack. No silence in time, unfortunately.
Yeah, they have a pounce up in just another second. He's gonna be silenced, but he should still be able to get himself away. Early Blink Dagger picked up by Moon. I think this is still a good game for the Blink Dagger. I don't know if we've had that conversation yet, Durka. What are your thoughts on Blink Dagger for Slark?
It's a lot cheaper, you can get it sooner, and it you know, sort of performs the same purpose. And with Shadowblade, you know, you're forcing the enemy to buy sentries and gem, things like that, so you have that side of the coin. But also, Blink Dagger, it offers you something Shadowblade doesn't. Because if you use Shadow Dance, and you've got those, you know, few seconds to get the Blink Dagger off cooldown and blink away. Oh, NS in a lot of trouble here.
Ooh.
That Ion Shell.
Yeah, the Ion Shell Slark combination is pretty disgusting right about now.
Because if you use your ultimate as Slark, and then you want to try and get away, you've only got a few seconds. If they're continually chasing you, they see that smoke cloud running away, they're going to be able to catch you, even if you have Shadowblade, especially if they have Dust. With a Blink Dagger, it gives you that chance to blink to somewhere unreachable, or, you know, jump over a cliff and create a greater distance between you and them. And then the other way, it also gives you a greater initiation range, so I really like it.
Yeah,
but, you know, there's so many factors that make Blink Dagger a better item than Shadowblade.
Yeah, honestly, I wasn't too sure about it. Sometimes, even when dealing with like really big tanky lineups, I don't like it so much. But I was talking to the Mousesports guys when they were here, and obviously they ran Slark a couple times to great success, and they kind of felt like Slark is right now the next big hero that's going to be picked up in the meta constantly, more than it is now, like just kind of constantly. Blink Dagger, jump in, going to be able to find Jotam, and should burn him out here with the Dark Pack with the Ion Shell as well. That Blink Dagger, already, like, you have a lot of incentive to be aggressive here, but when you have the Blink Dagger and the Ion Shell, just this burst damage coming out from the Slark makes this Blink Dagger all the more effective.
And the panic sentry from the Treant. He's like, oh, guys, what do I do?
Yeah, I have no idea about that one, but he's blocking out his own camp attack in the process, so.
Smile has a blink, and he's smoked up on top, ready to go, but PR just packing the hell up.
Did they, I guess they didn't spy anything out with that ward, huh? So, Arzart now going to be heading into the mid lane now, trying to pick off Moon.
Not
Blink
an easy
Dagger's,
task, though.
Blink Dagger's almost up for the Brewmaster, too. Oh god, Illidan just morphed, he just waveformed forward, he's now going to get caught a little bit, but fortunately it was already start morphing strength before the silence came in, so he's going to be fine. Working towards that Blink Dagger as soon as possible. Do you think the Blink Dagger is really necessary here, or would you rather see a BKB for this game? It's quite the mix of single target and AoE disables.
On who, sorry?
On the Morphling.
I guess you meant Lincoln's and not Blink Dagger?
Yes, I did. I'm sorry.
I was like, Blink Dagger on who?
Where
the puck?
Yeah, I don't know. Something about the Slark still in my mind, I guess.
Well, Lincoln's is, you know, it's going to give him great split push potential, give that mana and HP regen, allow him to tank creeps a little bit and waveform as often as he wants to. So, you know, you've got that side of the story. BKB, he might go that as a second item and just go fully defensive. So they've got, you know, teamfight capability 25 to 30 minutes in. But I don't know, Illidan's one of those guys. He goes Lincoln's into Ethereal Blade and tries to kill people. Radiant's middle tower
is under attack. And he does have a lot of incentive with all these squishy heroes on the side of Power Rangers to try and go for that kind of pop. We do have the tier 1 tower about to go down in the middle lane. Radiant's and Arzard's still looking for that pickoff, man. He has yet to use the lasso, I think, all game long. Radiant's middle tower and is hoping to find the opportunity here, but Radiant's unfortunately going up against the Vengeful Spirit, who's already level 7, has the swap. Mixed in with a Slark having Dark Pack, there's just a little chance of him being able to find that kind of pickoff when they're grouped up together like that.
Well, it's been great movement from PR. He's either been in a position where he can blink lasso someone, like you said, just then, but PR are all grouped up behind that one hero he wants to focus, or he's been in a position where he can blink lasso someone and there's no one behind him to follow up. So I don't know if it's, you know, a mixture of VP trying to play this to late game, like you mentioned with that Morphling, and not wanting to go for these engagements, but then why pick Bat?
Right. I mean, yeah, I guess the early pick on the Mac, well, J4 is going to get picked off at the bottom lane. Leap was already in cooldown, but even if he did leap, he was still probably going to go down there. Meanwhile, the mid lane, though, they are going to try and pick off the Bat Rider. Moon not wanting to dive into the tier 2, and this time in the round, it's going to be Virtus Pro's chance to just group up and push down to tier 1 tower, taking this offlane tower. Not quite as important as the mid tower, but it's still just a little bit extra gold that they desperately need. The faster they can get the Lincolns, the earlier Illidan is going to be able to start focusing on that split pushing.
Yeah, as a Slark, what do you go for here? He's got Blink, so he's got the initiation. Do you go for Skadi to buff out your stats? A Basher to try and lock someone down? OG, in a bit of trouble here.
He's going to be able to get off the ultimate, though. The Fire Panda already stunned up, so there goes a large source of his damage. He's going to Cyclone up the Mirana and turn all the attention over to that one. Instant silence, nicely done. Overgrowth is going to be able to hold in. Good swap coming out. It's going to be able to stop that lasso. Scandal gets off, a decent silence on the side. Morphling needs a waveform, but it's not going to be able to catch the puck farther down, though. Slark is just tearing it up right now as he gets a double kill. Thanks, well, the Ion Shell actually gets the double kill for Darkseer. Three heroes go down, and they only pick off the Mirana. In exchange, Illidan gets himself to the top lane, but that is exactly why Virtus Pro do not want to be looking for team fights so early.
Well, it's so difficult as well when you've got four heroes that you want to try and focus down. NS went for the silence on the Mirana, which was great, so she couldn't leap away, but they took so long to finish her off. Then Morphling went for the puck kill. Darkseer came in, no silence left for him, so he got a nice vacuum wall. And then you've got Brewmaster running up to the left, Morphling running to the northeast, and then you've got the rest of your team getting demolished by a Slark. If you don't focus one hero down or try and, you know, at least concert your efforts towards Puck or the Mirana or the Slark, one of them is going to rip you a new one. Radiant's bottom
tower is under, you know, what's funny about that is that Fire Panda being stunned up by the arrow probably made a significant difference in the team fight, because like you said, they couldn't kill the Mirana fast enough because the Morphling was focused on someone else at the time, wanted to get greedy with the kills when they really just should have focused one person down. They had that Fire Panda, they killed the Mirana faster, they have extra damage to be able to throw down, and maybe would have contested that team fight a little bit better. J4 is about to get caught though. Fortunately, he runs back to his tower because he kept going up. Still gonna get picked off by the Batrider though, and oh no, miscommunication there. J4, oh man, he's gonna be able to get away. That's no good. Arzard and NS, yeah, that should not be happening at all.
And we see a really early gem on FNG.
Oh, Scandal's going to be able to find two here with the Coil. They're going to go for Jotam. They don't have any vision, so instead they're going to be able to find the Batrider on the side. FNG. Oh, they found Jotam. It looks like they do have some vision.
Yeah, early gem on the Venge.
Oh, there it is. I was looking, I was like clicking on heroes. I was like, where is it? Where is it? Gem for Venge. I mean, it makes sense when you have a Slark. It always makes sense to get a gem when you have a Slark.
Yeah, you're always going to know where their observers are, and Treant is going to have a pretty bad time. His Nature's Guise is almost useless now.
Yeah, I think Virtus Pro just, they got too greedy with their draft. I think they have such a pickoff-oriented, I think they just took for granted the Brewmaster was going to be able to win them team fights. But Power Rangers have really good team fight of their own. They might be able to find FNG here on the side. They do have the dust for the Moonlight Shadow, revealing him. We'll be able to get that kill. J4 is going to be searched away, so nicely done by the Darkseer. The Blink, nowhere enough in range. And a whole entire Brewmaster Ultimate just used for a Vengeful Spirit. Well worth it for Power Rangers.
Well, they lost the Tier 2 as well, so they didn't even manage to defend that important tower at mid.
Yeah, not a good sign for Virtus Pro, which is why they need to be able to take the small advantage that they have right now and push it into grabbing a Tier 1 tower. The problem is they just didn't quite. I thought maybe the Brewmaster would be enough mixed in with the Darkseer. Or not the Darkseer, sorry. The Batrider pickoff would be enough to be able to find enough kills to force Power Rangers back from these towers, but the Living Armor just isn't coming into play because they can't actually find the pickoffs. If they can't find the pickoffs, Power Rangers just overrun the tower and there's no Living Armor saving you.
And then they've got Dark Pact and Ion Shell burning through those Living Armor charges as well.
Mm-hmm.
Now, where's Illidan hiding? So he had a replicate sent up to top lane. He tried to waveform over the top of PR at mid to try and force them back off the Treant, but they just really didn't care. That waveform tickled them. Look at this, J4 hiding in the trees, Illidan hiding in the trees, and Cheshire Cat has a Midas of his own.
So I think it makes sense. I think it makes sense, like, looking at this, you go, okay, the enemy team wants this to go late. but we can kind of mitigate some of that late game by grabbing Midases of our own, so we can still hold on to a gold advantage even as we are taking their towers and that sort of thing. If we're not focused on farming, we still keep that farm up with Midases. But top lane, we're going to have Cheshire Cat get picked off by the lasso, the follow-up wave for him. They should have enough damage with one more nuke. Oh my god, Cheshire Cat. Oh my god, the arrow comes in right on top of the replicate that Morphling was going to be jumping to, and Cheshire Cat lives.
Not sure if intended, but pretty damn good. I agree with you. They've got complete map control. They've got the levels they wanted. Oh, Puck jumping in on G.
Oh, if they can kill God, they tried to land the arrow. Barely lived long enough to be able to get off his ultimate. Now they blow up the Marauder real quickly. Thanks to the Skywrath Mage ultimate, they do find that pickoff that might be able to win the team fight for them. Scandal's going to go down next. Now letting go FNG to drop him in the middle of five heroes. That's what you want to see out of Brewmaster ultimate right there, is being able to actually win the fight 4 versus 5, which is basically what a Brewmaster makes it with that Cyclone. Finding the pickoffs and then just dropping that hero.
15 HP on the Brew before he got his ultimate off.
That was ridiculous. Oh my god, the vacuum comes in, gonna be able to blow up the Skywrath Mage. Slark does a huge amount of damage. How many times do you see a vacuum into a Dark Pack combo? That is just really that ability you don't really think about as being truly AoE in team fights.
And Smile got the gem. I just wonder, will he put that in base or just go and D-ward now? Saying that, there aren't many wards up on the map. VP have a nice aggressive ward up in that dire jungle, but PR, same story. There's one about to expire over towards the mid lane. But they've got no rune wards, no wards near Roshan. But then again, neither team really has a Roshan taking side.
Yeah, Power Rangers just have a little bit of minus armor for the Venge, but not much else besides that. Virtus Pro have pretty much nothing except for, I suppose, Morphling going full Agi. But that's risky when you're on the Radiant side, so. May get picked off here. Stun, trying to get it. Silence goes out in time. Now they're going to be able to follow up with the stun. Can he morph into strength in time? The arrow lands. Still morphing into strength, and he's going to be fine. He can replicate away now. Now that he's no longer disabled, he just makes sure that he gets those extra disables out of the way. Moon, they tried to go for a kill on him with the lasso Skywrath Mage ultimate combo, but failed miserably, and Skywrath Mage, or the Slark, was able to bounce himself away.
That's the thing, that's Guardian Slark already, so 20 minutes into the game. He's got a hell of a lot of HP.
And he's going to find a pickoff onto NS, too. With this Haste Rune, there's just very little chance for them to be able to kill him.
And just Dark Pack through the Overgrowth.
Yeah, yeah, exactly.
It's such a painful moment when you Overgrowth or lasso a Slark and he's already hit Dark Pact, and you're like, okay, my big, big disable here, purposefully picked up for that hero, is now useless. Thank you so much, Valve.
Yeah, it's just one of those situations. I love the scenarios where you see, especially with missile stuns, where they hold on to it because they're waiting for the Dark Pact to go off. But the Dark Pack never goes off because the Slark is still waiting for the missile to be cast. And it's just like one of those back and forth things where it's like they never actually end up doing anything because the hero knows that once he throws out the missile, Dark Pact is going to go off immediately after that. It just kind of makes it useless.
Such a mind game skill.
Yep. Really is. Tier 1 tower is going to go down in the mid lane. Finally, Glyph being activated. But I don't think Power Rangers can get here in time. At least they could put it into Nye range. Illidan does have a replicate to jump to. 1 second, he's not going to be able to get the tower. Oh no, denied by Scandal. One of the few towers they could have gotten. NS is going to be cleaned up in the background. God is going to be able to hit a double clap here. Pops the ultimate. Maybe they can pick off some of these heroes. Good Overgrowth. Throws the Slark up, but he actually got a Dark Pact off there. Jotam trying to get himself away. Does have a Nature's Guise here. Not getting any distance, though. He knows. And he's not going to be able to get out. The Brewmaster ultimate is still up. It's going to go down in a second here, and he does have a clap. Blink away. And he will be able to get out. Virtus Pro losing 3 heroes in the process of just killing the Darkseer.
Yeah, that was one of the few changes that took me ages to realize why they did it. The Cyclone and Tornado being purgeable. It took me literally a week to realize that it was a buff to Slark. Mm-hmm. Because I was thinking, you know, you can't really target someone with Diffusal Blade when they're tornadoed, so what's the point in this buff? Like, why are they changing this? And I see it happen in the game. Like, oh wow, okay, Slark can get out of tornadoes now. Radiant's top tower has fallen. Because I don't think there's any other interaction that can purge other than his Dark Pact without targeting.
Yeah, I mean, besides the AoE purge of the Storm Spirit Panda.
Oh, yeah, true.
The Brewmasters. Yeah, Storm. I never know what to call that. It's not a Storm Spirit Panda. I keep... What are they? I keep calling them Brewlings. Is that the right word?
I've taken that name up as well. I don't know who started that, but I just call them Brewlings as well, because you've got Spiderlings and Brewlings. And it just makes sense.
Yeah, I think a friend of mine was... Yeah, he called them Brewlings, and I was like, that's a good word for it. I like it.
Technically, like, they're called Storm, Fire, and Earth aspects of Brewmaster, but really roll off the tongue. You can't say the Storm aspect is now getting the Tornado off.
No. Yeah, because I was looking at the skill, and he just specialized warriors. Storm Warrior! No, that's not going to work. It's not going to work for me. Illidan almost has Ethereal Blade, so it's getting about to be that time. They need it soon, too, man, because they're just kind of getting overrun by Power Rangers left and right. They only have one Tier 2 left. It's getting to the point where you're just about to see Power Rangers pick up the next Roshan, and then they can start going uphill, in which case you have to have that Ethereal Blade. Because you do have a lot of potential for pickoff, not just from that, but the Ethereal Blade leading into the Mystic Flare as well. Batrider's going to be able to grab Cheshire Cat here. The ultimate goes off on the side. Good use of the swap there. And we'll be able to save Cheshire Cat. FNG looks like he's going to be fine, as well as the Fire Panda stunned up once again. FNG looking to be able to stun up Arzart, but he won't be able to get it. FNG should be falling here. He has the urn taking him up just enough to be able to survive. Overgrowth on the side. We do have Moon living through that. Good use of the Force Staff by somebody there in order to get him away. It looks like the rest of Power Rangers will be able to fall in line and chase back the rest of these heroes. Scandal. Oh, he can't afford to lose this gem. He doesn't have the Lucery Orb up, and he's going to be taken down. The gem is on the deck. Jotam's going to be able to grab that one, and I thought really with the one-for-one trade there, I really thought that Power Rangers could have been able to take that fight. Now the vacuum in, wall goes out as well, and now the follow-up. Here comes Moon trying to pop Jotam real quickly, is able to do it. And there's the turnaround that I expected to see 30, 45 seconds ago, but they just didn't have it now. Trying to get the lucky bash onto Illidan. Continues the pursuit. They actually find him. Illidan, Ethereal Blading up, but he's losing a lot of health here. The last bit of burst damage is going to be enough to kill him.
That first hit bash.
Yeah, that
How
was...
How mad are you, Illidan?
That was pretty legit.
I was just wondering what the rest of VP were doing, because they had two heroes in here, the Brew and the Bat, find Cheshire Cat. Mm-hmm. The rest of PR came around, but they managed to stop VP, you know, following up, because they had three heroes standing here, the Treant, Morphling, and Skywrath, who didn't follow up into the fight, you know, for a good 10 seconds. Mm-hmm. Whereas if I thought, you know, if they had come over the ridge as Morphling, or, you know, just looped around, they could have taken that fight much sooner. And I think the Slark Dark Pacted Overgrowth again. It's getting really bad.
Probably. Probably. Aegis now going to be picked up by him, so he can go straight for the Abyssal without any fear of being popped in the team fight, because he's got that backup Aegis. And there's should be really nothing stopping them, I think, from going uphill. I don't think you want to wait for the Abyssal. At the same time, they actually don't have a team that's incredible at physical damage. So maybe at least the Manta on Mirana, which is coming up soon. But other than that, just aggressively hunt for a pickoff and any chance to be able to go uphill.
Yeah, I think they just push two lanes at once, get mid and bot pushed out, because mm-hmm. they're going to be the easiest to get up to high ground. If they want to go the safe route, then they probably go to tier 2 at top, and then try and find a pickoff and control the enemy jungle. But they've got to find a pickoff. They can't just go up high ground, I don't think, unless VP are completely out of position and they're sitting in front of their tier 3s where Slark can just jump on them. But is this a smoke from VP? No, they're just going to walk through their own jungle, not smoked up or anything. Look for the loop around. Illidan in trouble, hexed up.
Yeah, they're going to throw down the wall, whatever burst damage they can get onto Illidan, because they know that Strength Morph is being so damn terrible. He waveforms away. Now the rest of the team comes in. Power Ranger's going to get blown up on the side here. Moon is focusing on NS, thrown up in the Cyclone now. And they're just going to focus on the puck in the meantime. Is going to be able to blink away. Now Moon comes back down looking for NS. Gets silenced. Another Cyclone goes out. Now Scandal may be thinking about coming in as Arzart is held in place. Finally, his Firefly runs out. Moon intercepted. Gets the pounce to the side, though. Not able to survive. Aegis being popped. Silence onto NS. Orb is able to grab him. Arrow comes through the side, is able to snag Jotam. And Moon just moves on. He wants as many kills as humanly possible. God trying to teleport away. Where's the bash? He doesn't get it. Scandal, though, he does get the gem on the side as he kills the Batrider.
Such a great position to win a team fight as well, right outside the tier 3 at bot. What are the buybacks like on VP? Even if they have them, I don't know if it's worth doing it now because their respawn timers are so low. They could probably let the tier 3 get to, what, a third HP or just 4? Oh, they've got 4 to 5, so yeah. They'll mostly be alive before this goes down.
Yeah, they need to keep the tower alive at the same time that if they could have, living armor would have kicked into play and they probably could have healed up the tier 3 back to full health before Power Rangers were ready for another push. That was the one thing I was concerned about is I was like, they need a pickoff, and even once they have the pickoff, they try and go uphill, but they're still fighting with living armor. So if they don't actually take down that tower, it's going to be healed back up. But now Power Rangers able to do it, the bottom lane, I think that's their biggest hump that they have to get over. Because now they can go bottom again, just slowly work on the range racks or something like that. And it'll be much easier when they do find the pickoff to fully commit to a whole set of racks now that they don't have to deal with the tier 3.
Yeah, line drawn on the map. They're going the safe route, though. Go up to that top tier 2, push that out. So then they can pressure one lane on top and have the creeps do that naturally. And then go bot and try and take racks there. Do they have travels on anyone yet? I think Darkseer is probably going to build travels as his next item. Is it on the courier? No, he's got a blink.
That makes sense with the scythe device that he already has mixed in with vacuum. He could use a good tool of initiation.
Yeah, I was just thinking more along the lines he could split push top and then TP down to bot once they engage in a team fight.
Mm-hmm. No, I think that's a smart idea as well. You see the Slark, he's already picked up an Eagle Song, so he's going to be able to have a Butterfly here fairly soon. I'm surprised he didn't go for the Abyssal, just because of how important the Lockdown is versus a Brewmaster, versus a Morphling. Moon's going to be fine. He was able to get off the Dark Pact as the Silence went down on him, and just bounced himself away.
Yeah, or even a BKB on Slark, because we saw that last fight. VP would have been completely rolled over if G didn't get, you know, 2 Cyclones onto Slark. So if he can dodge these stuns, you know, he's going to get Dark Packed off on one of these spells at least. He's been really good at doing that, Overgrowth especially. But if he can dodge these Cyclones, dodge the stun from the Earth Panda as well, Silence on top of that. Oh,
swaps in Arzart. They're going to try and blow him up real quickly. Ethereal Blade not going to be able to save him in time. Jotam takes a lot of damage there from the Mystic Flare. Still going to be taken down. NS is going to go down next as the orb cops him on the side. Brewmaster and his ultimate coming out, trying to focus on Scandal, but Power Rangers just turn, fight this. However, they have the Morphling coming in for a second blood. Oh no, the Scythe of Ice. They're actually going to be able to hold him in. If they can get it some additional stuns, they got him easily. And now the Brewmaster is going to come back, instantly silence, unable to blink himself away, and that's going to be a total wipe.
Oh look, Slark was on 200 HP, then he goes and sits in the trees for 5 seconds, and oh look, he's on full HP and killing everyone again.
Yep.
So ridiculous.
The power of that hero. Well, we're going to have GG being called by Virtus Pro, so the first game in this best of 3 does go the way of Power Rangers in the Tech Labs Cup Season 2 Minsk. I don't even know if I'm saying that right, but Minsk Glen event.
I'm not going to correct you, so.
Fair enough. Fair enough. I figured you were. All right, guys, stick around. We're going to have game 2 coming up after just a short break and a nap. A nap, too.